Hi, my name is Ginger. Thank you so much for joining me for today's practice. In this class, we'll do 60 minutes of chair yoga themed for the senior population. What you will need is a stable chair. I have mine on my yoga mat, but just make sure it's not going to slide out from under you. And then I have a yoga strap, but if you don't have one of these, maybe grab a belt. You could grab a scarf, maybe even a dog leash. And then also I will be offering some options with a couple of yoga blocks. Another option with those would be to stack up some books maybe. And we're just gonna start off today's practice by sitting up nice and tall, maybe roll the shoulders down the back a few times. And then as you're ready, you might begin to soften the gaze, maybe close the eyes. And just taking a moment here to notice this transition from whatever you were doing before this until you arrived on your mat right now. Maybe notice a change in pace, a change in energy. And then you might notice any distractions, any sounds inside or outside of the room. And just taking a moment to acknowledge those things, maybe releasing judgment, no good, no bad, no right or wrong, just noticing. And then beginning to shift your awareness to the sounds of the body, your breath, maybe beginning to listen so intently inward that you can hear your heart beating. Maybe noticing here where in the body you can feel each breath. If you'd like, you might begin to deepen your breathing, elongate your inhales and exhales, making them the same length. Following the air as it enters the nose, travels down the throat all the way to fill up the lungs as the belly expands, the chest rises, and then following the air as it leaves the body, maybe warming the upper lip as it exits the nose. Maybe bringing your awareness to all the points in the body that the ground, that your chair reaches up to support you, anchoring through your feet, rooting through the sit bones, and finding a slight lift in the pelvic floor, drawing the belly button in towards the spine and up slightly. Shoulder blades, once again, draw down the back, and you might imagine a string pulling the crown of your head up towards the sky here. Continue breathing deeply. Go ahead and bring your hands to your tummy here without closing the eyes. Just place your hands on the belly and see if you can continue to take these nice deep inhales so much that the belly presses into the hands. And then notice how it softens with each breath out. And maybe here, as you continue to breathe, you might begin to allow the corners of the mouth to curl up, finding this soft, gentle smile. taking one final round of breaths. Big inhale, fill up the lungs. Feel the tummy pressing into the palms. And exhale to let it go. Beginning to flutter the eyelashes open, allowing one ray of light to enter at a time. And we'll begin to find some gentle movement. So as you inhale, reach the arms out and up as high as you can. Exhale to bring the palms together, touching them right down through your heart center. We'll do that same thing again here. Big breath in, reaching up as high as feels comfortable in your body. Exhale to lower the palms. And one more time, just like that. Big breath in. Big breath out. Good. I'm working on a little bit of cross body movement. Take a big breath in, and then as you exhale, slide your thumbs over towards the left armpit. Inhale to pull the thumbs back through center. And same thing, taking it to the other side. Exhale, sliding the thumbs over towards the right this time. And exhale to draw the thumbs back through center. And we'll continue with this time adding the gaze. Take a big breath in here through center, and exhale to slide the thumbs over towards the left while you take your gaze over towards the right. Good. Inhale, pull it back through center, gazing through center, thumbs come to the heart. And exhale, thumbs slide over towards the right, gaze over towards the left. Good. Inhale, pulls us back through center and switching sides. Exhale, thumbs to the left, gaze to the right. Inhale through center, continue pressing those palms together. Exhale, slide the thumbs to the right, gaze over the left shoulder, towards the left shoulder. Inhale draws us back through center, and we'll exhale here. Awesome, big breath in. Again, we reach up as high as we can. This time, as you exhale, cactus the arms, bend the elbows, shine your heart space forward as you squeeze the shoulder blades together. Inhale again, reaching up as high as you can. And exhale, palms draw down right through the heart center. And we'll release the hands towards the thighs here, beginning to trace circles with the nose, moving in one direction, and taking it nice and slow here. These really mindful circles. Avoid crunching in the back of the neck. And if you notice any points of tension or tightness, spaces that need a little bit of extra love and care, maybe you hang out there for a bit. You could rock the head from side to side in any spaces that need that extra care. And then if you haven't already, go ahead and switch directions with those circles. Moving nice and slow, following the breath. Maybe you even connect your movement with your breath. Inhale to slide the nose up one side of the circle. And exhale as you lower the nose down the other side. One more round. Awesome, and the meeting back in center, we'll take the right ear over towards the right shoulder. Maybe the right cheek comes towards the right shoulder. Just finding that angle that feels really good in your body. Know that my options don't have to look like your options. This is your practice, so do what serves you. And then just noticing that lengthening in the left side of the neck. If this feels good to you, hold it here. Or if you'd like, maybe you play with bringing your right hand to the crown of the head, guiding it a little bit lower into this stretch. And if you decide you don't like that option, just lower that right hand back down. No need to commit to it. And then from here, go ahead and reach your left hand over towards the left. As you inhale, slide the left hand up towards the side. even with a shoulder, if possible. Exhale to slide the left hand back down. Good, inhale, sliding that left hand up. And exhaling to lower, maybe incorporating the wrist here. Inhale to press the back of the palm into an imaginary wall as you slide the back of the hand up. And then flipping the hand, pressing that palm into the imaginary wall. Exhale to lower it back down, painting the wall. Same thing, big breath in. Flipping the palm, we'll exhale. Awesome. Release your hands if you lifted them. We'll rock the head through center and then take your left ear towards your left shoulder. Maybe your left cheek towards your left shoulder. Again, finding that angle that feels good to you. Maybe reaching the left hand to the crown of the head and guiding it a little bit further into this if that feels good to you. And just taking a moment here to notice the sensations, this lengthening in the right side of the neck. Maybe you notice if it feels any different than it did on the other side. Just acknowledge that. Notice it. And then as you're ready, we'll reach the right hand over towards the side. Take a big breath in as you draw that right hand up that imaginary wall to your side, even with a shoulder, if possible. And exhale to slide it right back down. Good, again, inhale, reaching those right fingers up towards the right. And exhale, we lower, adding on that wrist motion. Inhale to press the back of the palm, slide it up that wall, and flip the palm. Exhale to slide the front of the hand down that imaginary wall, painting it with your fingers. Good, same thing, inhale, back of the hand slides up that wall. Flip the wrist and exhale to lower it back down. One more time, just like that. Big breath in. And exhale. Awesome. Release your hands here. We'll rock the head through center and sit up nice and tall. Moving through a few shoulder rolls with a breath. Inhale to roll the shoulders up the front. And exhale as they lower down the back of the body. Again, inhale, roll the shoulders up the front, shrugging them towards the ears. Exhale as you slide them down the back. And one more time there, inhaling up the front of the body. And exhale, we lower. We'll switch directions with that. So this time, as you inhale, slide the shoulders up the back, and then exhale to take them down the front. Inhale, shoulders slide up the back, shrug them towards your ears, and exhale to lower. One more time there, big breath in, big breath out. Awesome, maybe you shake out the shoulders, give them a little wiggle. And we'll come into some cat-cows. So bringing the hands onto the knees, as you inhale, trace a vertical line going up with the nose. Open in the chest, maybe lifting your gaze. Exhale as you trace that line back down with your nose, round in the back, pull your low ribs in towards the spine. Again, inhale to lift the chest, maybe lift your gaze for cow. Exhale to round the back for cat. And last time, inhale, lift the chest, lift your gaze. Exhaling to round. And we'll continue with this, maybe this time beginning to trace circles with the shoulders. So as you inhale, open in the chest, rock the shoulders through the side, the center, and then leaning towards the other side, rounding in the back, and then sliding the shoulders over towards the other side, opening in the chest to move through the front and lean to the other side. Go ahead and continue with this with your own breath. With each inhale, you open the chest, coming through cow, and exhale, moving through the back, rounding in for cat. Go ahead and take one more here. And we'll switch direction, same thing. Reverse your circle, inhale through the front, and exhale as you round the back. maybe incorporating the neck here. If you want to start to rock the head from side to side, following the movement of your spine. And then taking one more round, just like that. Big breath in. And we exhale. Awesome. Coming back up to our seated position. And then preparing for a forward fold. So if you have your blocks, you could place them by the feet. You might also place a block on top of your lap, and you can bring your forearms to that block if that feels good. Wherever you are, take a big breath in, find length in the spine. And on your exhale, begin to hinge the hips, leaning forward. So again, maybe your forearms come to the top of that block. Maybe they come down to your thighs. Maybe the upper body softens over the legs. You could bring your hands to your blocks or towards the ground. And maybe see if you can soften in your neck here. Relax and let the head hang heavy. Maybe nodding the head a few times, yes. Inviting your confidence, inviting your inner strength. Shaking the head back and forth, no. Releasing any worries, any doubts. And then finding some stillness. Maybe bringing your hands to the tops of the blocks. Maybe again, you might place them on the lap. But as you inhale, find length in the spine. Pull the shoulder blades together, creating this long line from the tailbone up through the crown of the head. Really rooting through the feet. Again, drawing the low ribs in. Take one more inhale here. Exhale to round it back down towards that forward fold. Same thing, inhale to lift halfway, find length in the spine. And this time coming right back down as you exhale, we'll lower. One more there, inhale, half lift. Exhale to lower. Rooting through the sit bones, and then maybe reach one hand to the top of the thigh if it's not already there. Reach the other to the top, and then use those hands to press up, coming back up to our seated position. And then removing your blocks, if they're in your way. We'll start to move our hands a little bit. As you inhale, stretch your fingers out wide, really spread the hands open. Exhale to clench the fists, squeezing them in closed. Again, inhale, spread the fingers out wide, maybe give them a little wiggle. Exhale to clench the fists. Once more, we inhale, spread the fingers out wide, give them a little wiggle, give them a wave. Exhale to clench the fists. And now bringing your awareness to your feet, as you inhale, lift the heels, start to come up on the toes. Exhale to lower the heels down. Maybe you lift the toes. Again, lowering the toes. Inhale, we lift the heels. And exhale to lower the heels. Maybe lift the toes. Last time, lower the toes. Big breath in to lift the heels. And exhale, lowering the entire foot down to the ground. We'll do both of these together now. So as you inhale, spread the fingers out wide, lift the heels, come up on the toes. Exhale to lower the heels, clench the fists, maybe lift your toes. Again, lower the toes, inhale, lift the heels, spread the fingers out wide, maybe wiggle them. Exhale to clench the fists, lower the heels, maybe lift the toes. One more time there, inhale, heels lift, fingers spread out wide. Exhale, lower the heels, clench the fists. Awesome. And now if you have your strap, your belt, your scarf, your dog leash, whatever prop that you have, go ahead and grab it. And I'll offer you a few different options with this. Maybe you also use a towel. You could use a towel or a blanket. And we're gonna thread the strap underneath your right thigh, grabbing it in each hand. So again, you can do the same thing with your towel, with your blanket. And then with this, we're gonna use our hands, Shift your weight to the left foot and begin to lift that right leg to hover. So partly using your arm strength to pull that knee up, but also working in the hip flexor to lift that right foot to hover. And then beginning to trace some circles with that right knee, moving in one way. Continue flexing in your right foot, toes point back towards the shin. And then go ahead and reverse directions with that circle. Continue sitting up nice and tall. If you notice the upper back starts to round and pull your shoulder blades together, sit up nice and tall. And then we'll release that, lower the foot down, and then switch the strap over towards the left thigh. And shift your weight to the right foot, anchor into that right foot, and then begin to lift the left foot to hover, using that arm strength, a little bit of work in the biceps too here, beginning to trace circles this time with the left knee as you sit up nice and tall, maybe find your smile. And then we'll reverse the circle, same thing, continue flexing in the left foot, and finding your breath. If you've lost it, return to it. Good, and then we'll lower that down here. We'll remove the strap. And then as you're ready, bring your hands to the back of the head. If this isn't comfortable for you, you could also bring the palms to heart center. Maybe you cross the hands in front of your chest. Whatever works for you. We'll take a big breath in. Again, sit up nice and tall. And on your exhale, start to twist towards the right. Using your obliques, inhale, pulling back through center. And exhale, this time twisting towards the right. Good, inhale, back through center. Same thing, exhale to twist towards the left. Inhaling back through center, we'll switch sides, exhale, take it to the right. Inhale back through center. This time as you exhale, twist towards the right and then hold it here. Maybe you release your hands. You could bring your right hand to the outside of that right thigh. Your left hand could come to the back of the chair. With each inhale, we sit up a little taller, find a little bit more space between each vertebrae. And then with each exhale, we're able to sink and settle into that space that we've created just a little bit more. Maybe taking this twist all the way from the base of the spine up to the neck, up to the eyes, bringing your gaze to the left corners of the eye socket, stretching out the eye muscles just a little bit. Make sure you're being really gentle here. Don't force anything. Taking a few more mindful breaths. With your next inhale, gaze forward, unravel, and then again, bringing your hands maybe behind the head, maybe to the chest or to the heart center. Inhale through center. Exhale, we'll twist towards the right. Inhale through center. Exhale to take it to the left. Inhaling through center. Exhale towards the right. One more on each side. Inhale back through center. Exhale to the left. And last one, inhale through center, exhale towards the right, and go ahead and stop here. We'll lower the hands, bring your left hand to the outside of that right thigh, right hand to the back of the chair. Inhale to find a little bit more length in the spine, sit up a little taller, and exhale, maybe twisting a little bit deeper. Again, maybe taking this twist all the way from the base of the spine up to the neck, this time bringing your gaze to the right corners of the eye sockets. And you might imagine your spine here is like a damp cloth. And you're wringing out any tension, any worries, and tapping back into the present moment with each cycle of breaths. Again, inhale, we find length. And exhale, we settle into that twist. One more round of breaths here. With your next inhale, take your gaze forward, unravel. And then standing in Tadasana, bringing your arms out to the sides, fingers pointing down, palms shining forward. Inhale, sit up nice and tall. Maybe you close your eyes here and just take a moment to notice any changes in the body, any changes in your energy, in your breath, in the temperature of your skin. Just notice. And then fluttering the eyelashes open here. We'll take it to some hamstring stretches. So if you have your block, this is a great place to grab one. You can place it out in front of you here. And then we're gonna kick your right heel out on top of that block. So it could rest on your block. If you don't have a block, no worries. We'll just set that heel down on the ground. Maybe you inch yourself forward a little bit in your chair if that feels more comfortable to you. And taking as much of a bend in this right knee as feels good to you. It doesn't have to be a straight leg. Just make sure you're sitting up nice and tall. We'll take a big breath in here. Maybe you place your other block on your lap again, like we did with that forward fold. And then as you exhale, begin to lean forward, hinging forward, until you feel a little bit of sensation in the back of that right hamstring. And continue to create length in your spine here. So taking this as a hinge in the hip, see if you can lead this stretch with the chest. Shoulders stay pulled together away from the ears. And we're flexing in that right foot. So drawing the toes back towards the right shin. Take an inhale here, and then as you exhale, maybe see what it feels like to dip your right toes out towards the right. Allow the right knee to follow, trailing in that same direction. Notice if that feels different at all in the hamstring, in the hip. And then on your next breath in, we'll rock the toes through center. If that didn't feel good at all, we'll skip it on the next side. Feel free to just keep your toes pointing right in center if that feels better to you. Again, this is your practice, so please do what feels best in your body. As you're ready, go ahead and press your hands into your thighs and use that to sit up nice and tall, returning to our seated position. We'll bring the right foot in and then kicking the left heel out here. We'll do the same thing. Maybe you grab your other block, place it on your lap. Inhale to find length in the spine. And exhale as you hinge forward, leaning forward. Left toes flex back towards the shin. And we breathe. Again, if you like to play with this here, if this is accessible in your body and it feels good, take an inhale here, and on your exhale, start to dip your left toes and your left knee out towards the left. Noticing if this side feels any different. It's really rare that our bodies are perfectly symmetrical, so if one side is feeling a little bit different, that's totally normal. Just notice that. With your next breath in, we'll rock the knee, rock the toes back through center, press the hands into the thighs, and use your exhale to come back up, lifting you into our seated position. Bring the left foot in to meet the right. And then we'll move through a few cat-cows, placing your hands on the knees. Inhale, lift the chest, lift your gaze, fill up the lungs. Exhale to round in the back. Draw your belly button towards your spine. Inhale, lift the chest, lift your gaze. And exhale to round. Once more, we inhale to lift the chest. And exhale to round. Inhale, sit up nice and tall, finding length in the spine. And then we'll move through some of these same postures that we just saw once more. So as you inhale, reach the arms up as high as you can. Exhale to bring the palms together right at the heart center. Inhale, reach for the sky, really take up space. Exhale, palms lower down through the midline. One more time, big breath in. Big breath out. Continue pressing the palms into each other. Inhale here. Exhale, slide the thumbs over towards the left, gaze towards the right. Inhale, gazing through center, thumbs slide through center. Exhale to slide the thumbs to the right, gaze left. Inhale, back through center, once more on each side. Exhale, thumbs slide to the left, we gaze right. Inhale, back through center. Exhale, thumbs go to the right, gazing left. Meeting in center on our next breath in. And we exhale. Coming into a forward fold here. Inhale, find length in the spine. Exhale, begin to hinge your hips and lean forward, stopping wherever is comfortable for you. Maybe ragdolling a bit from side to side. Again, softening in the neck. If possible, let the head hang heavy. Noticing the sensations that arise in the hips as you rock a little bit from side to side here with the shoulders. Go ahead and find some stillness. Maybe bringing your hands to your blocks, maybe placing them on the thighs. Inhale, we find length in the spine. Tailbone and crown of the head reaching in opposite directions. Pull the shoulder blades together. Exhale to soften back down, forward fold. We'll do that same thing again. Inhale to lift halfway, find length in the spine. And exhale to lower. Root through the sit bones here. Use this pressing into the thighs to begin to roll up the length of the spine, vertebrae by vertebrae. The shoulders and the head come up last, and finding your seat. Grabbing your strap whenever you are ready, take your time. We'll thread the strap underneath your right thigh. Shift your weight to the left foot, and as you inhale, lift the right knee up. We'll slide it out towards the right. And exhale, gently lowering it down the edge of that circle, pulling it back towards your midline. Inhale, lifting it up. Exhale, lowering it down the right side. Continue tracing these circles, connecting with your breath. Inhale to lift it. Exhale to lower. Once more, inhale, we lift. And exhale, we lower. Go ahead and switch directions. This time, inhale, lifting the knee out towards the right. Exhale, lowering it down your midline. Inhale to lift. Exhale to lower. Keep those shoulders lifted. Inhale here. Exhale to lower. One more time. Inhale. And exhale. Release the foot. And then we'll switch the strap over towards the left thigh. Rooting through the right foot, take a big breath in, begin to lift the left foot to hover. And then knee traces out towards the side, exhale, lowering it on the edge of that circle, pulling it back through, inhale, pulling it up. Exhale, sliding it down. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale to slide it down. One more time there. Big breath in. Big breath out. And switching directions. Inhale up the opposite side. Exhale to lower down the center. Inhale up the side. Exhale down the center. One more time. Inhale up the side. And exhale down the center. We'll lower it here. And we'll release the strap here. Go ahead and place it off to your sides, preparing for those twists. So again here, maybe your hands come behind your head. Maybe they come to heart center. Maybe they're at your chest. We'll take a big breath in. Sit up nice and tall. Exhale, begin to twist towards the left. Inhale, returning through center. Exhale, twisting towards the right. Inhale, back through center, really using those obliques to pull you through center. Exhale, take it to the left. Inhale, through center. And this time, exhale towards the right, and then go ahead and rest here. Lower the hands, bring the left hand to the outside of the right thigh, right hand to the back of the chair. Inhale to find a little bit more length, and exhale, sinking into this twist. Remember, taking it all the way from the tailbone up to the crown of the head, if this feels good. Maybe gazing towards the right corners of the eye sockets. On your next inhale, gaze forward, unravel. And we'll prepare for the other side, bringing the palms back to the back of the head, or maybe at the chest. Maybe your palms come together. We'll inhale through center. Exhale this time, twist towards the right. Inhale through center, nice and slow. Exhale over to the left. Inhale back through center. Exhale again, moving to the right. And one more time, inhale through center. Exhale to take it to the left, and go ahead and stop here. Release your hands. Right hand crosses to the outside of the left thigh. Left hand comes behind the chair. Inhale, create space between each vertebrae. Sit up a little taller. And exhale, sinking a little bit deeper into that twist. Maybe gazing towards the left corners of the eye sockets. Notice if you're holding any unnecessary tension here. Soften in the jaw, unfurrow the eyebrows. And find your breath. On your next inhale, gaze forward, unravel. We'll exhale for Tadasana. This is mountain pose, reaching the fingers out towards the sides. Draw the shoulders together behind the back. Sit up nice and tall. Take a big breath in, big breath out. Inhale to reach the arms up as high as you can. And exhale to cactus the arms, bend the elbows, shine your heart space forward. Good, we'll inhale again, reach for the sky. Exhale, palms lowering down through the center, preparing for our hamstring stretch. Maybe grabbing your block and place it out in front of you. We'll start with the right heel, kicking it on top. Big breath in to find length in the spine. And exhale, we fold forward, hinging at the hips. And stopping wherever is comfortable to you. Continue flexing in the right foot. And again, bending that right knee as much as serves you. And really see if you can use this engagement of the core, this drawing inward of the low ribs, let that core engagement be what pulls the upper body down a little bit further. Hold it here if this feels good to you, or maybe take a big breath in, continue flexing in the right foot. Exhale to dip the right toes and the right knee out towards the right. Inhale to rock them back through center, press the hands into the thighs, and exhale, lifting back up. We'll switch feet, bring your right foot in, kick the left heel out. Inhale, find length in the spine. And exhale, we hinge forward, leaning into this hamstring stretch. And again, noticing if this side feels any different. Maybe you notice if this feels any different than it did the first time that we did it earlier on in class. Hold it here if this feels good to you. Take a big breath in, really drawing the upper body down with the abdominals. And if you'd like, exhale, dip your left toes out towards the left. Knee trails in that same direction. Inhale to pull it back through center, press into the thighs, and exhale to lift, press up. Returning both feet to the ground. And then starting to cool it down just a bit. We'll take a figure four stretch. So a few options with this. You could bring your block to the inside of the left foot and place the knife edge, the outside edge of your right foot on top of that block, allowing the right knee to fall out towards the right. So maybe you're here. Maybe you extend the left leg forward, sliding the block a little bit closer, maybe towards the ankle. And then again, taking the outside edge of your right foot on the block there. Or maybe you cross your right ankle over the top of the left shin. You could even plant your left foot on the ground and bring your right ankle to the top of the left thigh, if this feels good to you. Wherever you are, make sure it's a place that feels comfortable in your body. We're flexing in that right ankle. Take a big breath in wherever you are. And then maybe as you exhale, you begin to hinge forward, leaning forward just a bit, if this feels okay in the hips. And if you notice any pain start to arise, come out of it immediately. Maybe take a different option. And see if wherever you are, again, you continue to draw those shoulder blades together. We're opening in the chest. And we're breathing. Go ahead and bring your right hand to the outside of the right thigh. And then gently closing your right knee in like a book. We'll switch sides here. So planting your right foot and maybe bringing the knife edge of your left foot to that block. Maybe it crosses on the top of the shin, or again, maybe on top of the thigh. Find what feels good in your body. And then take a big breath in, finding length in the spine. Exhaling to hinge forward. Maybe notice any stickiness, any tension, any resistance in the body. And maybe we can just consider this tension, this tightness, to be communicators. What is it trying to tell you? What does the body need? What's it trying to express? Maybe it's telling you to ease up, come out of it a little bit. And then from here, gently pressing into the top of that left thigh, lifting yourself back up, left hand comes to the outside of the left thigh, and then we'll close it in like a book, bringing both feet to the ground. If you'd like, you could take another forward fold here, softening the upper body over the legs, over your block on your lap, and just draping the shoulders, the arms over the legs. Bringing your hands to the tops of the thighs, press into the feet, press into the palms, and gently coming back up to our seated position. We'll take one final neck stretch, just like we did at the beginning of class, bringing your right ear towards your right shoulder, maybe the right cheek towards the right shoulder. And then you have that option to bring the right hand to the crown of the head as well, if you'd like. Breathing into the left side of the neck, allowing each inhale to create a little bit more space, release a little bit more tension. And with each exhale, you soften just a little bit more. Go ahead and release the right hand. If you lifted it, we'll rock the head through center, and then taking the left ear to the left shoulder, maybe your left cheek to the left shoulder. Option to bring the left hand to the crown of the head. And breathing into the right side of the neck. We'll release the left hand. If you lifted it, rock the head through center and coming back up to lengthen the crown of the head towards the ceiling. And you're welcome to close the eyes here if you like. Just trust the sound of my voice to guide you through this last bit of movement. Go ahead and lift your left hand and then reach your right hand across to grab onto it, using the right thumb to begin to massage the palm of the left hand, maybe sliding that right thumb from the center up towards the knuckles, towards the fingertips. And just giving yourself some love, some appreciation, maybe taking a moment to consider all of the things that your hands do for you in a day. Maybe even working your way onto the pad of that thumb, onto the wrist, maybe even rolling out the wrist a few times if that feels good. And then as you're ready, no rush at all, you're welcome to stay here for as long as you'd like. We'll switch sides, so bringing the left thumb to the right palm and beginning to massage the right hand. Maybe you tell yourself thank you. You say your name, say I love you. Being really kind to yourself, really appreciative that you took this time to care for yourself and be with yourself. Again, maybe making your way to that right thumb pad, maybe towards the wrist and rolling out the wrist a few times. And then again, no rush at all. You're welcome to stay here for as long as you'd like. Continue loving on yourself. But if you're ready, we'll take one final resting pose. This is called Shavasana. And if you have a blanket, this might be a great place to wrap a blanket around the neck and use your hands to add a little bit of tension so that you can lean your head back into that blanket. Maybe you take a moment and readjust, place your chair up next to a wall, or if it feels good to you, if you're comfortable with it, you could even come to lay on the ground. We're just gonna take a moment of stillness here. Allow yourself to lean back in the chair, and if you haven't already, soften the gaze, close the eyes, maybe bringing the palms to rest on the lap. Soften in the face, again, unfurrow the eyebrows, unclench the jaw. And you could even kick the heels out in front of you as well. Maybe bringing them to the tops of your blocks, if that feels good. Allowing a wave of relaxation, of surrender, to travel from the top of the head to the tips of the toes. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Noticing any thoughts that come up here, and continue to redirect your awareness back to the breath, back to those sounds of the body, your beating heart, releasing any control of the breathing, just noticing that natural flow. Enjoy your rest. Shavasana. I invite you to rest here for as long as your schedule allows, really breathing in the benefits of our practice. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for joining me today. The light, the love, the teacher in me sees and appreciates that in you. Namaste.